Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers, with an update on the Kyrie Irving situation and the trade talks that are taking place between the Brooklyn Nets and Los Angeles Lakers. Going to dive into it. Still reason for optimism that a deal ultimately gets done, but make sure you do subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that notification bell as well. I'm going to keep you updated on everything going on with this and everything else with the world of the Los Angeles Lakers. All right, let's talk about LeBron and Kyrie and where this is all at right now, because Mark Stein on his fantastic Substack said just a little bit ago that he is optimistic that Kyrie does still land with the Lakers, and he gives a couple of reasons. Now, he said, for one, Kyrie, from what he's heard, is actually in LA right now. Now, Stein mentioned that's not necessarily the reason why he believes that Kyrie ultimately lands with the Lakers, though, nor should it be. Look, a lot of NBA players have offseason homes in LA. A lot of guys spend time in LA. So Kyrie being in LA isn't necessarily a sign that he's going to the Lakers or anything. We've seen this over the years. A lot of guys spend time in LA. It's not a sign that that's where they're going to wind up. But I mean, it's just something to kind of file away. Now, Stein says the reason why he believes that Kyrie ultimately winds up with the Lakers is because of LeBron James. He said that LeBron wants Kyrie on the Lakers. Specifically, Stein explains it like this. James, I'm told, wants to see Irving in Lakerland more than anyone. What other team, furthermore, has a LeBron-sized personality with the experience to cope with all the chaos that comes with adding Kyrie? James, remember, has often thrived in chaos. All right. So essentially, you've got a couple of things here. First and foremost, it's LeBron wants Kyrie in Lakerland more than anyone. And remember, LeBron is a guy who can sign a contract extension in August, August 4th. He can sign an extension with the Lakers. The Lakers would certainly like him to sign that. That's going to give him a pretty loud voice, as though he didn't have one already within the organization. He can kind of use that for leverage, right? Like, hey, you get this Kyrie deal done, I'll be open to doing this and this on my next contract. So there is some power right there. LeBron wanting Kyrie, that matters. And again, even if that contract situation was not the case, was not in play, LeBron is still going to have a pretty strong voice within the organization. So obviously that's going to matter. On top of that, you look at the situation the Lakers are in right now with Russell Westbrook. Clearly LeBron, AD, Russell Westbrook did not work at all. So there's a lot of incentive right there, aside from LeBron saying he wants Kyrie, to go ahead and try to make this move, get the deal done, and move on with a big three that fits on paper a lot better than Russ, LeBron, and Anthony Davis would. You add in Kyrie Irving's shooting. But then the second part of that, the bit about, well, the Lakers are the only team with LeBron on it. There's a sense that Kyrie Irving, when you look at what he's done, he hasn't had success since his time in Cleveland, right? Things blew up in Boston. Things blow up in Brooklyn. Hasn't had success. It's been a disaster. And we've seen him leave a couple of franchises now kind of in a lurch. LeBron may have been the guy that was able to sort of rein in Kyrie and really make it work. And so when you add that in, are other teams seeing this going to look at themselves and say, yeah, we've got a team that has that personality, that guy that can bring in Kyrie to the organization and get the best out of him? A lot of teams will balk at adding Kyrie simply because of that. In fact, former Suns GM Ryan McDonough was on Twitter earlier and was asked to rate how attractive the contracts of Russell Westbrook and Kyrie are, how attractive those players are on a trade front on a scale of 1 to 10. And he listed Russ as a 1 and Kyrie as a 2. Other teams are not enamored with Kyrie Irving. However, the reason why the Lakers are going to want to get him is, number one, because they've got Russell Westbrook. And so Kyrie, while he provides some headaches, Russ provides headaches too. They've already got those problems. And then if you're able to get Kyrie, he's an upgrade on the floor. Other teams are not in that situation. Other teams aren't going to want to bring in headaches. The Lakers are looking at it as, we already have a headache. Let's get a headache that fits better on the floor. So that is certainly a factor. And then if you're another team, are you looking at yourself and saying, you know what? We've got that guy that is going to really make Kyrie focus in on what we're doing here and is going to get the best out of him. And if not, that's going to scare a lot of other teams away. In addition to all the other factors, including Kyrie only having 1 year on his deal, he can tell everybody he wants to go to the Lakers, which is what we've been hearing has been happening. Look, everything is pointing to Kyrie ultimately winding up with the Lakers. The question is, what is it going to take in order to get the deal done? Now, last night, we got that report from Chris Haynes and Ian Begley, both saying that there was optimism on the Lakers side that a deal could even get done today. So that's something that's important to note. Optimism there that a deal could get done. And then as soon as Haynes put that out, we get a pushback, right? We get Chris Haynes putting out there that, well, the Nets organization says it's just preliminary talks. So what's really going on here? Let's read between the lines a little bit, because there was a report this morning that other teams, specifically the Mavs and the 76ers, were interested in a Kyrie Irving trade. Keith Smith and I talk about this all the time on the NBA front office show. Read between the lines. Who benefits? Where is this coming from? Most likely, and this is my guess, just trying to get a read of the situation, what we're seeing happen is the Nets are pushing back on what this deal with the Lakers in order to get some leverage here. Look, everybody knows that the Nets are going to move Kyrie. Everybody knows that the Lakers appear to be the only landing spot. So, of course, getting information out there that, oh, no, wait, we've got these other teams that might be interested too, in an effort to try to get the Lakers to raise their price, to raise the price that they'll pay, that makes a lot of sense from the Nets side of things. And of course, shortly after that came out, we got reports from within those specific teams, the 76ers and the Mavs, that they were indeed not very interested in Kyrie Irving and not pursuing this situation. So again, you've got a little bit of a battle going on in terms of leverage between the Lakers and the Nets. And if Chris Haynes' report is accurate, essentially what they're battling it out over is the Lakers want Seth Curry in the deal with Kyrie. Remember, Kyrie for Russ straight up doesn't work because Russ makes so much more than Kyrie. So something else has to come from the Nets. The Lakers want that something else to be Seth Curry, who only has 1 year and just over $8 million left on his deal. The Nets want it to be Joe Harris, who was 2 years on his deal and is making $18 million this coming season and then $19 million the following season. The Lakers don't want to absorb that long-term salary, in addition to negotiations between draft compensation. How much are you going to give up? And certainly there's going to be a sliding scale there. Perhaps the Lakers can say, okay, well, if we take Joe Harris back, which, by the way, both of those guys would be great fits, Seth Curry, Joe Harris, if healthy, both of them have dealt with ankle issues, but if healthy, both of them provide the shooting that the Lakers could certainly need. But the Lakers could use that as a negotiating point. Say, okay, well, if we're going to take Joe Harris, then we're only sending one first, or something like that. You can use that as a give and take in the negotiation. But bottom line, I think what's going on right now is we are still continuing to see all signs point towards this getting done. Again, Mark Stein highlighting that LeBron wants Kyrie, and that tends to mean things are going to happen. But we also have this pushback now from the Nets, which appears to be an attempt to gain leverage in order to get the Lakers to blink on whatever it is that they're stuck on at the moment. Keep in mind, it's possible as well that none of this goes down until a Kevin Durant trade is decided upon, which might take a little bit of time because those trade packages are going to be massive. There's going to be a lot to sift through for the Brooklyn Nets. Could wind up being a multi-team trade. Heck, Kyrie Irving to the Lakers could wind up getting roped in to a giant Kevin Durant trade as well. It's what we saw with the Russell Westbrook trade last year with the Washington Wizards, where multiple teams, including the Brooklyn Nets, actually wound up getting pulled in. So that's always possible. So Lakers Nation, buckle up. This could happen at any moment. It could happen a week from now. It depends on whether or not the Nets are dead set on the Kevin Durant thing has to happen first and how far along those talks are. We just really don't know exactly when this is going to go down. But again, right now, everything we're hearing points to the fact that number one, the Nets and the Lakers are indeed negotiating. And number two, it does appear that the Lakers are probably going to be the Nets' only option to truly find a Kyrie Irving trade, which to me suggests that ultimately this will get done. Lots to take in, I know, but let me know your thoughts on this whole situation in the comment section down below. Don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that notification bell as well. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.